Welcome to an exclusive interview. Sanjay Kumar Verma, IPS ADG Chief Vigilance and Security Officer, Mahana. Sir, India Unknown में आपका स्वागत है. Could you please share your childhood days, family background and your formal education with our readers?
Yes, I am born in the city of Muzaffarnagar in Uttar Pradesh. I have spent my early childhood in cities of Bareilly, Shahjahanpur, then Nainital and Agra. I did my B.Tech mechanical from the Albag University in Agra, and my father was a police officer in the UP police. He retired as inspector from Bijnor in 2000.
It was your dream to become an IPS officer since your childhood?
My father somehow drilled this into my head that in India civil services are one service that scope that give you maximum scope of serving the nation, maximum scope of serving the common man, and that is what you must aspire for. I had a brilliant career otherwise. I had almost 7 job offers when I completed my engineering. I was first in the gate examination 1988, okay, in mechanical engineering in all India. And I also went for doing my M.Tech in robotics in the Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore.
Okay.
But then seeing my inclination for the civil services, I dropped that idea and I appeared for the examination, IT8 examination.
To fulfill the dream of the...
Exactly, you can say, or I would still now at this end, at this juncture I will say that it was destiny.
Yeah, exactly.
You may plan so many things in life,
exactly,
but then destiny takes you wherever you are supposed to go.
That's right. What are the memories of your 1990 batch? Do you meet sometimes your batchmates?
Yes, I have very fond memories of the batch. We had a wonderful time in the academy. All of us were very close and very good friends. We get divided into various squads. So I belong to the squad 5 of the 44 RR, the regular recruit batch.
Mm-hmm.
And we have very, very fond memories of that period. We recently had our reunion of the batch in 2015.
Okay.
And then we got a chance to mix with the families of the batchmates, the spouses, and we had a very healthy interaction in the academy.
Oh.
Thereafter also now the modern technology has brought us close, and we are all on the WhatsApp group of 44 RR.
Okay.
And that's a very lovely group, very lovely and lively group.
Yeah.
And we exchange all kind of social media stuff. And it has been a very nice and long journey with all the batchmates.
Do you plan sometimes to get together, meet in the once in a year?
Yes. After the group came into existence on WhatsApp, there have been several reunions and small meetings of the batchmates all over the country at various points of time.
Kindly brief us about your earlier postings. You served as a IGP in Kolhapur range and many.
I actually started my career from Kolhapur, and I was SDPO Ichalkaranji to begin with.
SDPO?
Ichalkaranji.
Ichalkaranji.
That time Ichalkaranji was the biggest subdivision in Maharashtra, Ichalkaranji and Bhusawal. I had, as SDPO, I had 21 police stations under me. And they were the biggest subdivisions in Maharashtra that time. I was lucky to get a chance to hold charge of such a big division. Thereafter, I was promoted as additional SP Ahmednagar. And in that short stint as additional SP, I also got a chance to be the SP Nagar I was holding the additional charge of SP Nagar for some time. Thereafter, I got my regular charge as SP Jalna. That was way back in 1998, and I was there for almost 2.5 years. After doing my stint at Jalna as an independent SP, I was DCP in Pune for a very long time. I served in Pune city from 1998 to 2002 as DCP in various capacities, as the zonal DCP, as well as the crime branch, special branch, and almost all the zones.
Thereafter, I did a stint as commandant SRPF Group 7 Dhaund. After that, I was posted as SP Buldhana, thereafter as SP CID in Nagpur, and then I was promoted and I was DIG presence for the entire Marathwada at Aurangabad, and I did a long stint there. Thereafter, I was additional CP Thane city as additional CP, as in charge of administration. From there, after on promotion, I went to Pune as IG presence again, and thereafter as I served in CID for a long time as IG SCRB and IG PAW. From there, I went as IG Kolhapur, and from Kolhapur on promotion, I came to the present posting.
Kindly tell us about your present posting and assignment as a Chief Vigilance and Security Officer in MHADA.
MHADA is a vast organization. Its authority came into existence in 1975, and the post of Chief Vigilance Officer is existing since 1980. This post was an earlier an SP rank post, thereafter got upgraded to DIG, IG, and now since the last 4 years, an additional DG rank officer is assigned this job. The vast nature of housing work in this authority and covering over five regional boards and four local boards. So there is a need for constant vigil over the various activities of officers and so many other factors. The profile has been upgraded, keeping in view the nature of job and the level of officers in the authority itself.
MHADA is a huge and big organization. What is your role as a Chief Vigilance and Security Officer?
The Chief Vigilance and Security Officer has a very important role in MHADA. As a police officer, he is supposed to coordinate with the police department and attend to all the complaints that come to his office. He is supposed to investigate those complaints and ensure that proper service is delivered to the citizens. Also, in case of any errors or any omissions and commissions committed by the officers, he is supposed to point out to the authority. So he has a check and balancing role in the entire organization.
People are blaming that MHADA is corrupt department where builders and officials cheat to the public and department as well. How you control the corruption in MHADA? Please comment.
See, it is wrong to make a sweeping statement like this. MHADA is a government authority and it is as good or as bad as any other department. We have to understand the genesis of the thing, the activities. Right at the inception, when MHADA was just in the childhood, in the initial years, the MHADA has officially appointed agents to promote the schemes, and those agents were supposed to get promote the scheme. They were supposed to get the clients, and they were given a commission by MHADA for this thing. Over a period of time, these kind of agents they developed a nexus. Collusion and with the officers here in MHADA, and they sabotage the entire functioning. Unfortunately, this condition persisted for a long time, and now corrective measures have been taken. Last at least 6 years have been very crucial in this matter. The lottery has now been digitized, it has gone online, so all these activities have been curbed, and now with the vigilance office playing a very active role, so many checks and balances have been introduced. All complaints are taken care of, and we try to nip the problem in the bud. Saying that officials cheat public and that this kind of a statement is not correct. You must understand the volume of the task involved here. The commissions and omissions are there everywhere, and likewise it is here in MHADA also. And unfortunately, as I said, this menace of the middlemen, which now MHADA is rigorously trying to get over and to do away with, we are making all out efforts to get rid of this menace.
How you initiate the action and resolve it when you receive any complaint against MHADA officials or any particular case in a specific project or in general?
See, when we here in the vigilance department, we receive various kinds of complaints. There are complaints of inaction by the various officers. Then there are complaints of wrong action, malafide action by the officers. Then there are some complaints of direct corruption. So various complaints are first categorized. In any complaint, the first step is to seek a report from the concerned authority, concerned officer, as to what he has done about this complaint, if he has received it already. Then we issue one or two reminders, and if we do not get an adequate response, thereafter we conduct a hearing, we summon the officer and call for his explanation, and the action taken report is sought. If it is not satisfactory even at that level, then it follows by the disciplinary action. But my experience is that most of the issues are resolved even before hearing is conducted, and in very rare cases the further steps are taken. But we have also come across cases where the complaints are quite motivated, and it is some sort of a cartel which is running in the organization, which they are indulging in putting up false complaints against the officer to blackmail them, and similar kind of racket is in the RTI section also, where very motivated and deliberate informations are sought under RTI, and then the misuse of RTI is also happening to some extent. But then that is only 10% of the entire volume of complaints.
According to you, what need to be done in MHADA to control corrupt practices in the public interest at large? What more need to be done?
Government had entrusted me this responsibility to study the entire functioning of MHADA and come out with a concept paper. I did an exhaustive study of all the boards in MHADA, and particularly in Mumbai. I studied various departments and the procedures and the complexities involved. And I have come out and I have given a concept paper to the government regarding this thing.
Okay.
So many things came out of discussion, and we suggested.
Government is secretary MHADA?
The housing department.
Okay.
And this thing. So many things have come out in that brainstorming, and we have recommended, and we are steadily now implementing those things. I will cite few examples. A lot of cases come up to us that the person has been cheated, and somebody, some con man, went and showed them and told him that we will give you some MHADA flats, and issued some allotment letters and this thing. So we made a recommendation that all the MHADA letters, the allotment letters of any kind getting out of MHADA should be carrying a particular mark. It should be in a coded form, and the moment you so which cannot be replicated outside. So that is one practice now we are trying to this thing. Then second time, the other instance is that whenever these lotteries come into existence, a lot of middlemen come into play, and then they start calling the clients. We had said that we'll make it a huge campaign that time, and we'll appoint nodal officers to come in contact with them for any kind of queries. So this scheme has been very successful, and a lot of middlemen activities have been curtailed by due to this. And so many other initiatives I can tell you. Then we about this, all the land holdings of MHADA, our records were not digitized. So we had said that we will develop a proper directory of all the land holdings, and then a proper system of guarding those properties, and various other initiatives have been proposed, and the work is going on these counts.
Do you think this Mahada posting as a ADG, it's a side posting?
It is a deputation posting where to the housing ministry. Okay. And I am really not very much comfortable with this idea of side postings and executive postings and this thing. As I said, if you are focused on your work and you work from your table, then I think all postings are same. And of course, there are some places where you get more limelight and where you are more in the hype. But then it is all about the hype, it is not about the work. Work if you want to do and you want to deliver and you want to serve the common man of the country. I have, in my experience, I have put in almost, on my 28 years of service, I have put in almost 16 years in side branches. And I found the work in side branches more satisfactory and more satisfying when it comes to delivering the service. Because here you are more focused. In an executive profile, you are running around the whole day. And at the end of the day, when you realize that what have you served, what have you really achieved, then the answers are coming, that are coming are very little. But here in the entire day, if I go back and I see what I have done, then I really find that yes, at least today I could sort out 5 complaints and at least 5 people, common citizens, went happy from my office. And that is a more satisfying feeling. Great. I have worked in the prisons department also earlier for a very long time. Yeah. My work and my experience in the prison department has been the most satisfying experience so far. Much more satisfying than the job that I did in policing ever. Lot of initiatives we took for the prisoners. Lot of initiatives. For example, I will quote a very small example. On a daily basis, in a central prison, almost 300 to 400 kilos of food is getting wasted, and it is coming out of the prison department. It is coming out of the prison. We just brought one small bacteria culture, and we introduced a system of producing the organic manure from that. Food. It became a very big success, and in my entire zone, in the entire Marathwada, I was holding that time as in my charge. Everywhere we implemented this scheme, and we used to sell this organic manure at the rate of 12 rupees per kilo.
Oh, in the prison itself?
In the prison itself. We had dug this composting, bacteria cultures, and every day we were putting these manures. So many other initiatives. The prisoners, when they are in the open jails, that time I used to send them for getting training in the local industries. This was an initiative nobody had taken earlier. So that time we realized that they have wonderful people. And today I can tell you, at least 4 of them are in contact with me, and they are doing very well. And each one of them has got a job per month as a qualified labor in an industrial unit.
Great.
So many other initiatives. So as I can say, this side posting and this executive posting, yes, as a youngster, we used to feel we are recruited to be the SPs of the district, and that time if you don't get a SP posting or a commissioner posting, you feel bad about it. But then over a period of time, if you are really serving, if your intentions are to serve the citizen, then you will find a more satisfying atmosphere in the side branches. So-called side branches.
Sir, what do you say on the traffic management system in the city?
I have not worked in Mumbai city on a direct charge so far. But as I can tell you that from my experience, whatever, as a common citizen, I can tell you the traffic, there are 2 things in Mumbai. One is the traffic and the second thing is the housing. Housing is what we have spoken about. Traffic is, it is what it is. Lot of initiatives the Mumbai City Police has taken, but they cannot. There are certain things which are beyond them. The space crunch, the vehicle number of registered vehicles on the road, and so many. But then I see on a daily basis how much of hard work our traffic police is putting on the roads. Every chalk and junction you see, every place you will find them, and you will see them doing their jobs. And it is one practice, one service that is the direct service to the common citizen. And I really congratulate Mumbai police, the traffic police particularly. It's a stupendous job, and they are doing a wonderful job about this. It's a challenging thing. Maintaining traffic today, while coming from New Mumbai, I got stuck up at the Mankurd
flyover, and that is why I got late for the interview.
Okay.
And every day this is the scene, but then every time you will find a quick response team from the traffic department coming to the spot, handling the situation, whatever it is on that place, and clearing the traffic and people moving. 1.3 crore people in this small island city, they are surviving and moving around from suburbs to the mainland and the main town and the main town to suburbs. It's a big chaotic place.
Whether Mumbai police is well equipped to fight against terrorist attack like 26/11?
I would not be an expert to say this thing, but then within the department I have seen a lot of initiative has been taken, and compared to the situation what we had in 2008, thereafter a lot of things have come into play. People, special forces have come into existence. Even the Mumbai police itself has come out with, has their own strike forces now placed at various strategic positions, and we are in a much better situation, much better capability and much better attitude to face an emergency if it at all comes on us.
So how much you are satisfied with the working style of our present Chief Minister of Maharashtra, Devendra Fadnavis?
We have been very lucky to have a very young Chief Minister, and we have seen his working style from very close quarters. Very sensitive and very responsive personality, and the Maharashtra police and the Maharashtra government has done very well in this thing. I am no one to certify, but then this has been our experience, this is what we have seen, and I would wish, personally I would wish him good luck and for the coming elections.
How much you are satisfied on working under leadership of present VP, Shri Milind Maheshkar?
Shri Milind Maheshkar is a very soft-spoken, very quiet officer. He is focused on his work, and I have absolutely no issues and working with him. He never interfered in my work and never checked or cross-checked anything. So we have been having a very comfortable equation so far.
What are your expectations from Government of Maharashtra and VP, from VP of Mahada, for your department particularly?
I would still feel that certain more inputs are given to the Vigilance Department, and the first thing would be the manpower, because the unit is very, very compact and the charge is all over Maharashtra. So we are able to do a lot.
How much of the team now, how much your manpower?
It's a very small compact unit of around 10 people, including the MADA officials, and then we have a post of an police inspector also. But the volume of complaints and the volume of investigation that we have to do, that is large, and we can comfortably expect the strength to grow by another 4 or 5, so that the other regional boards which are at Nagpur, Nasik and this thing, we can focus on those places also.
Sir, have you ever influenced by any political pressure in your work?
It's a very simple question. I have put in almost 30 years of service now, and I worked in various profiles all over Maharashtra. And barring one or two incidents, freak incidents, I have not encountered any kind of political pressure. This is the truth. These are certain perceptions, these are certain hypes created by various quarters in the present society, that there is a lot of political interference.
Sir, who is your role model? Whom you inspired much?
I am myself my own role model. I do not get impressed or inspired by anyone else. I am a self-made person, and I believe in absolutely one thing, that is hard work, perseverance, patience, and seeking the higher truth of life. Now, this is something which is difficult to understand and digest. I am a spiritual seeker, and I have advanced into the spirituality and the spiritual aspects of life through my constant perseverance, patience, meditation, and over a long period of time. So life is not so simple and so ordinary as it looks on a daily basis. The reason why we are born here on this planet, there are specific reasons why we are sent here, and if you achieve those reasons, then only your life as a human being is successful. Otherwise not. Otherwise you would come back again and repeat the same exercise.
Sir, which sport you like? How you are making fit yourself?
I was never a very keen sports person, but then I have always been a keen fitness seeker. Even today, I do my regular running of 4 to 5 kilometers and yoga exercises on a daily basis. I don't recall in the last 25 years, I have missed a single day without exercise.
Every day? No weekday off?
No weekday off. Okay. Rather on a weekday, I go more.
Sir, how you spend your leisure time, if find some?
I said I am a spiritual seeker. And the universe is really vast. The mundane knowledge on this planet, the life on this planet, is what we have already experienced and learned from. It is what remains hidden and what a human being should aspire for beyond a certain level is what I seek.
Which sport you like much?
I am a fond runner. Although I don't look like, my looks are very deceptive. But I am really, I can really run well, and I do believe in long walks and treks, and this is my hobby.
Sir, what suggestion and advice you want to give to the new students who wanted to become IAS, IPS like you?
All the new generation that is coming up today, I would only suggest, say, that you should be first of all clear in your mind as to what you are aspiring for. Today's are complex times where people are focused on so many things. There are career opportunities in every field. In our times, career opportunities were limited to very small fields. But then in today's times, there are career opportunities. Any, you name the science and you have a career opportunity in that field. So, what are you looking out for? First, set your own targets. And my message to the youngsters would be, go after personality development, go after your commitments, learn to help others, never miss a chance to help anybody else. Stick to your goals and discipline your life. Physical fitness is a very strong path. Once you have acquired physical fitness, only then you can go and aspire for spiritual fitness. If you are carrying a sick body, then sick body cannot aspire for anything else. So first achieve physical fitness, then go after mental fitness, and then seek for the higher truths of life, that is spiritual fitness. Thank you.
Thank you very much for your precious time. Aap the Sanjay Kumar Verma Sahab, ADG. And Chief Vigilance Officer Mahada, great personality, given answer of all questions, and India no really wish of your great great success near future, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Please subscribe India Unbound channel for watching latest interviews of celebrities, administrative officers and businessmen. We welcome your valuable suggestions and opinions. Please like and share our videos. Visit us. And do write us. Follow us on social media. If you have any queries and want to advertise with India Unbound Media, please call or WhatsApp us on